Hello guys, welcome back to my channel if you are new here, and welcome back for a brand new video. I feel like I have like a frog in my throat today, so apologies if you can kind of hear a little like in my voice, because I can feel it right now. But welcome back for a new video. Obviously, as you'll be able to tell from the title, this is going to be a Manchester vlog. I'm actually going for a really exciting influencer event tonight, and then me and Loz have decided to stay an extra night and just shoot content and get back into it, because I'm not gonna lie, I have been so off my A game with influencing and doing brand content, and I've just not been on it. And I am gonna give you guys a few life updates in this video as well, just so that you guys can be up to speed with what's been going on for me, what I've been going through, like things that have gone good, things that haven't gone good. But yeah, I am so excited. So it's Wednesday today, we're heading to Manchester soon. I actually got my hair done last night and I've gone darker, as you can probably tell. And I really like it. My hair feels so shiny. It's a joke. I don't know if the lighting's really picking it up here. I wish I showed you guys yesterday. I did go to film a video yesterday, but it was just gonna be like a sit down life updates video, and it was just a bit too heavy for me, so I didn't end up filming yesterday. But got new hair, got my nails done yesterday, just went for a classic French. One thing I have to tell you girls is, if you get normal gel, stop what you're doing and go to Biab, because honestly, this has helped my nails so much. They don't chip, even when I bang them, even when I'm like fiddling around with stuff, and you know how you can just get your nails caught? These have literally been solid. They're so much like thicker. They're still gel. It's still the same process of like getting normal gel nails. Let me just move you around here because I feel like the lighting's really crap. But yeah, it's just been really good. So absolutely love this. My LVL is literally running out, which is not ideal for this evening, because I just don't really wear lashes. I'm not really like a strip lash kind of girl. Never have been. So we're just going to work with this. Obviously, I have tan, so I probably look a little bit patchy and a little bit tanny at the moment. I wasn't going to tan because I do actually have like a nice natural base tan, but I think whenever you go darker hair, you always feel about 3 shades paler. So yes, I've decided to tan. I'm literally just packing up a suitcase at the moment, ready for Manchester. I've got a call in an hour and then I need to set off. So I do actually need to get ready, pack and sort everything in the next hour, which is not ideal, but it is what it is. It's absolutely fine. And basically what's also happened is, because of just like where my headspace has been, I've been a little bit here, there and everywhere, I actually missed ordering everything I needed to order for the trip. And also my collab, I think, only got sent out yesterday, which means it's gonna arrive today, which is gonna be too late because I leave for the hotel. So I have ordered a parcel to the hotel. So fingers crossed that arrives, and I've just reordered anything that I ordered on my collab as well, so that I've just got it at least, so that I can shoot it. So yeah, I just feel like I am here, there and everywhere at the moment, but I'm trusting that it's gonna go to plan and that we're gonna have an amazing trip. So I'm really excited for the event tonight. It's a Mars the Label event with We Shop, I think. It's like a double party, so really excited for that. It's at Rosso as well, which I've never been to, so I'm really excited for that. Just excited to feel nice and shoot as well. So yeah, I'll bring you along for that whole trip. We're picking Loz up at probably like 1:30, and then hopefully get to Manchester for like 2:30, check into the hotel, get the parcel, and then we're gonna shoot a few outfits and then get ready for the evening. Also, my friend Amy is gonna come over to our hotel and come to the event with us, so I'm so excited. So yeah, that is such a long-winded intro, but hello, welcome back to the channel. And yeah, I'm just excited to bring you guys along to Manchester. Also, really quickly, just gonna give you a couple life updates before like we get into like the bulk of the trip and everything like that. So a few things have been going on, some amazing, some not so. Business has been going amazing. I've had some super successful launches and I'm just so grateful. So I actually have 12 clients enrolled in my Ultimate Breakthrough program, which is designed to help women transform from feeling overwhelmed, overworked, underpaid in their business to a place where they have a clear strategy, they know where sales are coming in, they know who their client is, and they can operate from a place of abundance, not stress and overwhelm. So I've currently got 12 people enrolled in that. and we are like 4 weeks in now to this transformation. It has been incredible. I've made a hire in the business, so I now have an OBM, which is an online business manager, and a VA, which is a virtual assistant, who support me. I also invested $7,000, which I did not have, into business coaches as well, to make sure that I had like a soundboard to like run past my ideas with, make sure I was doing business properly. So yeah, there has been other things that I have done as well. I only made the hire like 2 weeks ago, so that hasn't played a role yet, but I think as the breakthrough gets bigger, it's so incredible to be able to give people opportunities to come on the journey with the breakthrough, and also great for me to have someone else's expertise. So business has been going great. I also launched a planner, which the orders end this evening, so you guys, if you're watching this, are not going to have time to be able to order them, but the planner is incredible. I might have time to quickly show you before we set off, but I just created the most perfect planner. It has to-do lists, brain dump space, priority versus urgency matrices, so that you guys can plan and actually just brain dump, offload, and prioritize what needs to be done, what needs to be put as a project. There's also journal prompts in there, goals, intentions, an actual planner as well, which is completely undated and untimed, so that you guys can not miss a page if you miss a day. I think it's really important that you just use it when you need it. And that's one thing that stresses me out with planners, is having a set like year and then missing a week because of whatever. And I've missed like 5 pages where I could have just planned something out. So it's honestly so aesthetic. It's so premium and high quality. I'm just in love with it. But the orders do cut off this evening, so it is a shame if you're only watching this video now. But make sure you check me out on the Breakthrough Society's Instagram, which is just at the Breakthrough Society, because I am looking at a way of fulfilling that passively. So because I'm going away, which I'll talk to you guys about in a second, I'm going away for over 2 months to America, Dominican, Tulum. It's a huge trip. And that's why I've not launched these planners as like a proper product, because I'm not going to be here to personally fulfill them. And it's also not something I actually desire to do in business. I've always wanted an online business. So I'm working out ways to be able to like drop ship it or send it to Amazon and sell it on Amazon. So I'm just working through solutions for that at the moment. But that's really, really exciting that's going on. And yeah, obviously I've got my trip, which is really exciting. So just a kind of heads up, there'll be so much content now of planning, prepping for this trip, literally you name it. I'm going to really try on TikTok as well. I've been loving TikTok recently. So yeah, there's just been a lot going on in business, like personal, like obviously so excited for this trip. Another thing that I have like just recently gone through as well, which I was so umming and ahhing over whether to share this on YouTube, is basically a breakup of somebody that has been in my life for a year now, and it has been the best year of both of our lives, and it is just shit that it's come to an end. And I have been offline a little bit just trying to heal, and you know, it did break me. Like, I think losing anyone that you care about so much is really, really hard. And I don't want to get into like the ins and outs too much. There's no bad blood. There is no like hatred or anger or resentment or any kind of bitter negative emotion, other than just sadness that right now, with where like we both are in our lives, it's just, it's not the right time. And I've been somebody that's never, ever, ever believed in right person, wrong time. I always think if it's the right person, it's never the wrong time. But I'm just trying to take whatever lessons I can out of this. It might be that that's my lesson, that actually you can meet people at the wrong time, or that this person wasn't for me, or I don't know what right now. I don't know what that lesson is, but I'm sure it will come. And I just want to say, like, the 5 years that I spent on my own did me the world of good, because the way I now deal with situations like this, I can only be proud of myself. Like, I do not flip, I do not raise my voice, I do not get overly emotional, I do not give anyone a hard time for making decisions based on where they're at, even if they hurt me, even if, you know, I lose out in that situation. The me now and how I handle situations is something that me 5 years ago could have only admired and been like, wow, I wish I could be that strong. I wish I could hold that love for people even when things are hurting. And I just feel really, really proud of myself. Obviously, I've had like my downtime as well. Like, I'm gonna have more days where I'm probably sad. Like, I'm grieving the loss of literally my best friend as well. So yeah, I don't want to get into it too much because I know I'll get upset, but it is something that just happens in life sometimes, and it's made me realize, like, I'm just really gonna knuckle down on business now. I'm trying to like make time for things as well that maybe I didn't before, such as like the influencer event tonight, because I'm just not ready to go out and like party. So I feel like this is a good excuse to kind of let my hair down, like just be around people and socialize again, but not have to push myself out where I'm like trying to force myself to have a good night when I don't even want to go out. So yeah, I just thought I'd give you guys the update of that. Obviously, it's been a little bit like up and down for me. Like, I train people every day, I coach people every day about becoming the best versions of themselves. So it only felt right that I treat myself the way I would treat anybody else, and that I teach myself the lessons that I would teach anyone else. So I'm really, really proud of how I've handled it. And yeah, I guess it's just a new chapter now, being single, being fully single, walking into this chapter with as open arms as I can. Obviously, I'm kind of dragging my heels a little bit because it just sucks at the moment, but I've obviously got my trip coming up, which is really, really exciting. So I can't wait to bring you guys on that journey. And it's literally not even that far away, which is so exciting. So yeah, I just thought I'd wrap up a few updates in this video because yeah, I just thought you guys, I feel like YouTube is the place where I can be like more myself, I can be more open, I can chat about things. So I just thought I would let you guys know what the deal is. And I got through it without getting upset. So this is a result. So I might go reward myself with a Starbucks quickly before my call, but I have now been chatting for 12 minutes. It's 20 past 10. I need to get on a call at 11:30. Oh wait, so I actually have longer than I thought. Okay, that's brilliant. But I just need to go grab a coffee, pack and get ready. And then let me pick up the camera once we're in Manchester, because I feel like this will be a horrendously long video if not. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed that one. If you didn't pause and grab a cup of tea, maybe do now. You probably need a breather as well. And yeah, let's get cracking for the Manchester trip. Just checking in. We're staying in the Leonardo tonight and then we're actually moving tomorrow, but look how cute this is. We're literally staying for two nights. This is just typical us. So this is the room. I'll just show you in here. I'm literally just waiting for Loz to come. But this is the room. She's here. Let me just leave that in the door. This is the bathroom though. How cute is this? This is the shower. It's cute, it's nice, isn't it?
It's bloody gorgeous.
I know, it does smell really nice. Perfume. We've got this little wardrobe, this bed, little sofa thing here. Oh, we've got tea, coffee, we've got little snacks. This is cute. So, first outfit, needs a steam, but we move. I don't really have time. We're in a little bit of a rush as per, but I've just paired it with these high dunks, which I'm not 100% convinced on because you can see obviously the black lace, but we move. I've got it on with this little Primark ribbed bralette, which I love. And then this blazer is from PLT. Again, it does kind of need a steam, but we're just going to work with it. Loz has lent me this bag as well. Let me see if you can see the outfit better in this mirror. Yeah, you can probably see a little bit better in here, but this is going to be fit one. Yeah, this is the current outfit. The only problem is I'm literally due on my period and we've got a period bloat. So, love that, but this is what I think I'm going to be wearing. Come show the vlog your sheen jeans. I'm not gonna lie, the lighting's a bit crap near the window. It's a bit blue. Look.
Oh yeah. Hala hala.
Wagam. Right, OOTD. PLT.
Course it's PLT.
Tan lines, UK heat.
Jeans, sheen, heels, public desire. Bags, helper.
Love. PLT. Lauren's wardrobe. Are you getting in? Come on in.
Miss Pat.
Zara. Shoes.
PLT.
I can get off. Oh my gosh. Come on in. So, I probably got like minimal footage of last night, but it was so good, wasn't it, Loz?
Yeah, it was really good.
It was like so nice, like interior, the decorations were so nice. It was so busy as well, which obviously like, it was just nice to see, because I think if you're ever hosting an event, like you just wanna have it full. So it was so good. We had Wes Nelson perform, we had a violinist. It was good entertainment actually. But we didn't really get too drunk, did we? So we went to Rosso for like how many hours? Maybe like three.
We got there, what time did we get there? Like half eight.
We got there about half eight, yeah. So we got to Rosso about half eight, and then we got to China White at like, God, midnight?
Yeah.
And I'm not gonna lie, when we did turn up, it was dead, but it filled up so fast because she basically had booked it out for the after party for the Mars event. So we stayed for like probably not even an hour, probably like just under an hour. But as soon as we got in, we just drank water anyway because we knew we had a busy day today. And you know when you're just not really feeling it, obviously you guys know the life update. So yeah, we just decided to come home and get some sleep. We've just planned all our outfits out to shoot today. So Loz is just packing her suitcase. I've got a bag behind me. We're gonna try shoot three outfits and then reward ourselves with some like breakfast or lunch because we're actually moving hotels today. So we stayed in the Leonardo last night and then we're moving over to the Edwardian, which is so nice. It's got a lovely pool. We've got some bikinis as well, which we need to shoot. So it's just a really, really good vibe. So yes, this is my OOTD. Let me just try show you guys. I'm a little bit worried that I look, I don't really know. I just don't know that this is my normal vibe, but I've just got my high dunks on, some cycle shorts, my new Jordan Breakfast Club tee, which I absolutely love. I don't know if you can see on the back, but it's actually got like a menu. I just think it's so sick. And then I've got these glasses, which Loz has kindly lent me to wear with the outfit. Look at Loz's side, they're just in the shot. It's all Loz can drink, otherwise she gets too drunk.
Although last night I didn't.
No, yeah, you had porn
stars all night.
Although them porn stars were not that strong, were they?
No.
But these are the glasses that I'm gonna try and rock for this outfit. So it's very monochrome, this.
Whoa.
I feel like very black and white, and then Loz is just packing, ready to check out. So we've just come to the Edwardian. Honestly, how much nicer is this than the hotel we've just stayed in? Honestly, it is absolutely gorgeous. It's got this like lovely staircase. It's so nice. Hi, Loz. Outfit change, don't mind my phone hanging out the pocket, but we've just checked into the new hotel, which is the Edwardian. I'm gonna show you guys the rooms. Now, let me just say, like, the rooms are not as nice as the hotel, but it's definitely worth it for the hotel because they're so nice. They're so accommodating. It's honestly, it's just incredible. There's like a library to work. There's a bar. It's just so nice. And Peter Street Kitchen is obviously inside. But quick fit check. So the whole outfit is Zara. Shoes are Nike Dunk. This is either Primark or PLT. But this is the room. So we actually did have a double room, but they've given us a twin so that they could fit us in earlier, which was super kind. But this is the room. These are the beds. It is quite like an old kind of vintagey. Well, I assume maybe it's like Edwardian, I assume, kind of vibe. But this is the room, and then this is the bathroom. So it's got a really nice sink. I love these sinks that are just like floating. Oh my gosh, look how cute this is. Like little earbuds, cotton pads, nail file. So cute. Loz is absolutely buzzing about this because she uses Ren skincare and everything is Ren. So that's a win for her. We've also got this lovely like wardrobe space. We've got some robes. I just love hotels that have stuff like this. It just makes it feel special. Extra pillows, a safe, laundry. And then this is the bathroom. So you've got a shower in there, bath there, and then toilet. So yeah, what do we give it out of 10, Loz? Do you want a room rate?
Room rate? Well, the Ren skincare knocks it up a lot.
Yeah.
But the room is a bit old and well, isn't it?
Yeah.
The overall service in the hotel is actually pretty good, isn't it? So I'd probably give it a
9 out of 10. Oh, look, you're in.
We're literally just ready now to go out for lunch and breakfast, and it is 1:43.
And we've not eaten.
No, we've not eaten. Let me flip it this way so we can see fully. Yeah, no, we literally didn't even eat though, Loz. We had
sweet sour chicken.
I haven't eaten. No. Whoops. Anyway.
PLT top, boohoo bottoms, Jordans, and I'm wearing my champagne topper.
Oh yeah, and we're wearing, not we, she yeah. is wearing. And then I've just got on PLT top, Loz's Telfer, Air Force, and then these are actually a charity shop find, which I put on TikTok the other day because I'm buzzing. These are like £3 something, so love it.
Thank you. That's really nice.
Hi. As you'll have seen, we literally have just come to Gusto. As you'll have heard as well, we literally haven't eaten since 24 hours ago, and even when I ate a little packet of crisps, so I am so excited to eat right now. So we've come to Gusto because we can basically fill up on so many carbs. We're gonna have garlic bread, truffle fries, truffle pasta, pizza. What else do you want to eat? Everything, anything that's carby. See ya. How excited are you? So, starters have just arrived. Loz has got a gluten-free one. I've got the normal one with rosemary and sea salt. Oh, perfect, perfect, perfect. So I've got the carbonara. We've both got the truffle and parmesan fries, and then Loz has got the ragu.
Yeah, beef ragu.
Beef ragu. Bottoms up. So we've literally just got back to the room, shot some outfits. We tried to reshoot the outfits that we wore last night because we absolutely failed at trying to shoot. It was so busy in Rosso because obviously there were so many other influencers getting pics, and we just kind of wanted to enjoy our night, so we didn't shoot them. But this is honestly what we are living in. We're trying to get an early night tonight because we want to get up and shoot some pool pics in the morning. And wasn't it quite busy when we went down? Yeah. Like with people, so hopefully we can go a little bit earlier and get the pics. But we've actually got our take home garlic bread because we couldn't finish it in Gusto, so we asked if we could take some back. So we're literally going to get in bed, have some garlic bread, have a little girl talk, have a little chit chat. Actually, you know what? I don't have a drink, like, I wonder if they'd bring one up. Should we maybe order room service? Line switch. Look at this. Night night.
Hello. Oh my god.
One more time.
I'm losing my fucking
shoe. So
say what Chris has he got? In Manchester Hotel. You better direct your call. Get hands up one more time.
I literally haven't even taken my mascara off. With a big sigh.
That is the Pixar lamp, though.
No, it is.
It is. I think they've stole it.
Shawnee. I think they've stole it. Good morning, guys. So we actually slept through the alarm a little bit this morning, didn't we? I just got a little prod on the shoulder and she was like, oh, it's 8:30. So we've slept in a little bit, but we've just got ready to go down and shoot. I've just got this like metallic-y bikini on, giving me very like Kim K Skims vibes. And then I've just borrowed these glasses from Loz because I feel like these will go with the vibe. Dior's, Dior's. Loz has left her sunglasses. So me and Loz have forgot to bring any form of flat shoes other than trainers. This feels so weird. So I'm walking to the spa in barefoot. Spa days. Is the gym in the hotel. It is so nice. It's in like, it almost feels like kind of cave vibes. It's so nice. So, me and Loz, as per usual, have overestimated the time everything takes. No, we've not over, we've underestimated. It's gonna take, what time is it? What time is it?
It's 7:53.
53, right, we've got 7 minutes to get up to the room, pack and check out, and we've got wet hair.
Typical us style. What time is it?
I don't know, my phone's off yet. I think it's like
11:45. And we're just checking out, here we go.
Funny thing, it just happened. This guy just came up to Loz and was like, hello, are you okay, madam? And she was like, yeah. He was like, are you not sunburnt on your nose? No, it's blusher. And then he came back over and he was like, oh, well, I was just gonna give you something. I thought you were like really burnt on your nose. And he was like, I didn't know if you need anything. And then what did he say? Like a makeup wipe. Oh, look at her. How's your sunburnt nose, Loz? You don't even look that sunburnt.
Well, apparently I look burnt.
That was, that had,
oh, I love
that was one of the funniest moments. Do you know what it was as well? Like, he showed no like apology. He was just like, oh, yeah, I was gonna get you some after some. Right, I need to order an Uber. We need to go home. We're actually gonna go to the Trafford Centre though today. I've just changed into this little top with, that's not a very good view of the outfit, but I'll show you guys when we get to Trafford. I know, we've literally just got to Trafford. Loz has just ordered gluten upon gluten.
And celiac.
But we literally, I know, and she's celiac, but we literally just turned up and we spotted Millie's cookies, so this is what I always get.
That's
$4.80. Thank you.
This is what I always get. It's like double and it's filled with all the icing. And then Loz has just got, what have you got? A Kinder
white,
one and
white chocolate.
White chocolate. It's just going to hide them.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, if this isn't heaven, this is our ritual also. Have you noticed? Every time we're in Manchester, we have to come for TGI's. Oh my gosh, look at that. Oh, I'm so excited, it is a joke. Look how cute. I actually really like this, you know, that's not even my vibe, but I love that. I love that. You smell my Millie's cookie?
Yeah.
What can you smell, Flo? Oh, she can smell the sausage roll.
Oh, what was
heading
it?
We are back home. So, apologies I didn't really film an outro yesterday, but drove home from Manchester, dropped Loz, came home, went to see my friend, and you know when you're just knackered? I've been trying all morning to like do errands and like get my returns done, clean the house, all that jazz, and I am just so knackered. But I'm actually working today a little bit because obviously I had 2 days just focused on shooting and I really wasn't on my phone, so I'm just having a couple of days now. So I'm just spending today catching up with the Breakthrough Society stuff, catching up with clients, catching up with all that kind of stuff. So yeah, it was such a good trip. Got so much content. I'm gonna give you a little sneak peek in my little preview app. I always use preview to plan. Plan my content. So yeah, if you want to see all the content that we shot so much. I'm so happy with it and it's made me feel so nice. Then follow me on Jessica Leeming on Instagram. It's Jessica Leeming _. And yeah, I am looking a little bit worse for wear today, so I'm going to sign this vlog out. Thank you so much for watching. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed and got to know what's going on as well. So thank you so much for watching. I'm sending you so much love and I can't wait to see you in the next video.